Hello.
Hi. Good evening, everyone. You didn't have to be quiet for the piano moving, but thank you so much. Yes, yes. Give them a round of applause. We always forget just like one thing. It's fine. And it was moving the gigantic 10-foot piano, so that's fun. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our last concert of the year. My name is Stacia Cammarano, and I'm the director of choirs here at Shadle Park High School. And we're so excited to hear have you here this evening. Just a couple last-minute reminders. Many of you have heard this now 5 times, but please turn off your cell phones, anything else that makes noise. If you need to leave during the performance, please make sure it's between songs or between choirs and not in the middle of songs. That's really distracting for everyone. If you would like to take photos or videos, please do not. If you look behind you, to your left, to your right, you'll see that we have some wonderful cameras here that are live streaming to YouTube, which is fantastic. So you'll be able to watch those after the concert, share it with family and friends. We will have some awards this evening, so if your kid's getting an award, I do understand taking a photo. But while music is playing and while we're singing, please refrain from that. I think that's the last announcement I have. Ooh, one more thing. We have a couple solos this evening. So instead of applauding right after they sing, please hold your applause to the end for those solos so you can enjoy the entire piece. But then please, yes, applaud for all of our soloists. Up first we have this evening is our chamber choir, and they'll be singing some really fun and beautiful pieces for you. As they get on stage, I'll just kind of set the scene for you. The end of the year is when we really get to celebrate seniors, celebrate students moving on, celebrate all of the stuff that we've done this year as a community and as a family. So we just have some really fun songs that we're going to be performing for you. So up first, the chamber choir. So That was a whirlwind, first of all. For those of you who are not musicians in the audience, that was a piece entirely sung on solfege, and yes, those were the correct syllables to the correct pitches. So technically, we wouldn't need a piano to learn that one, because every solfege syllable has a specific pitch that's intoned there, but we had a lot of fun with that one as well, so we hope you enjoy our one funny song of the evening. Next up, we have a really wonderful song. After two awards, I just looked down at my schedule. We have two awards, and then we have a wonderful song. So while kids get water and come back out on stage, perfect, that sounds good. We have two awards in chamber choir. So this is our awards concert, and we get to recognize two students, most improved and then most inspirational. So we'll start with most improved. And for when you're singing at a 7 a.m. zero hour class, I think the most improved student is someone who shows up every day, tries their best, is working consistently every day to apply what they learned the day before and apply it continuously and accurately. And the student who is voted most improved this year is someone who has consistently raised their hand to go through sections again, who has been really cognizant of mistakes that others are making and she is making. But then how do we fix those and can we go over that? And we need to do that again because she's just so diligent about making sure everyone's ready to go with their part. So she has improved in her own right, but she is also really instrumental in helping her section and the whole entire chamber choir improve. So we're really excited to offer the most improved award to Emily Albury. And so not only at zero hour, at 7 a.m., we're also trying to be better every day, which is really hard at 7 in the morning, to be better every day, to be better than before. We get to Friday and we just run out of steam. But we really need people in this choir who are an inspiration to me, to others, to the entire choir, because it's so hard to get up there with 11 kids and just like have a great day and just go for it. So we look for people who inspire us at that really early hour. And this person is always there, is always prepared, always leads by examples when it comes to knowing notes, being responsible, and helping others. And she's just a great example of what it means to be a kid in chamber. She's an excellent example, kind of that perfect, if you want to do chamber choir, be like this kid. So I'm really excited to say that voted most inspirational in chamber choir is Emma Hollingshead. So those are the two awards we have for this choir, which was really fun. All student voted and really wonderful recipients. But I will say that basically every name in this choir was mentioned and voted. So all of them are doing a fantastic job, which is really wonderful. So now we can move on to our next two pieces. We can finally go back to where I thought we were jumping. And I'd like to invite out onto the stage Devin Maxfield. She is a chamber orchestra player here at Shadle Park High School. And so I was so excited to find a beautiful song that features cello. And she's doing an exceptional job this year with our new instrumental director, Matt Wenman, and we are so ecstatic to have her with us for Going Home. The next two pieces are really kind of our serious ones for chamber choir and just a reminder for both kids and the audience that you always have a place to return to, you always have a home, and kind of that yearning for that familiarity and probably that familiarity that we get to create in this ensemble. So first up, we have Going Home.
Thank you.
last piece we'll have for you as a chamber choir is a really famous text. It uses a really famous text by Lord Alfred Tennyson, "There is sweet music here." And I would just want to take this time to remind the kids in the audience that 7 a.m. is an early hour, and you have gone through so much together at that hour. And without all of you, there would be no music at that time. So all of you come to that classroom at that time and bring yourself and bring your spirit and bring, yes, I know, and bring everything you have, and you bring that sweet music. And so we bring that to the stage this evening. So enjoy your last song together. There is sweet music here. So next up, I would like to invite to the stage Treble Tempos, who will be singing two wonderful pieces for you to start, The Lighthouse and Swing Down Ezekiel. So both really contrasting pieces. And Lighthouse is that reminder that you always have a light in the darkness. You always have someone there to support you, no matter the ups and downs of life or school or choir. And I think for many of our kids, choir is that class where they have that support and they get to look forward to those like really friendly and really supportive faces every day. And then Swing Down Ezekiel is just a really fun combination of two American spirituals and kind of the excitement, the awe, and just the impressiveness of kind of being reminded that there is always hope. So please enjoy Treble Tempos with their two pieces. Thank you. So next up, we'll do the two awards for this choir as well. Good job, guys. Yeah, laugh it out. You did a great job. Way to go. Yes, so for the next two awards, again, we'll do the same one. Student voted, most improved, and inspirational for treble tempos. So again, similar to chamber choir, I was so pleased that almost all of these students were voted for by their peers. Everyone in this ensemble has done an outstanding job this year, and I'm so proud of them. The student who was voted most improved is someone who shows up every day on time, tries her best, and then takes whatever suggestions I give her or suggestions that her peers give her, and she applies them right away, and she consciously tries to apply them day after day and keeps improving. And she's come such a long way from the beginning of the year, and we love having her in class, and we love having her work ethic. She is really like lighthearted and smiles when you give her feedback and just tries her best to be a part of the ensemble and to really sing and perform at the highest level, which is really inspirational, but also she has improved a lot. So I'm very happy to award the most improved in treble tempos to Marina Klein. And for our next one, we have most inspirational in treble tempos. This is a person who, when she comes to class, it's always with a smile. It's always with a great attitude. And sometimes also she'll just like throw in jokes and kind of tries to lift the atmosphere, even when I'm trying to have a really like serious conversation in class. But she just has to throw something in there, which she did today, which was wonderful. She just tries really hard to support everyone and be a team member of this choir and of this community. And I can't wait for her to sing next year with us because she's just such a positive community member and really inspires everyone in this choir. So I would love to award this most inspirational award to Malia Nelson. She's practicing for graduation in 2 years. All right. Very nice. You're wearing the same robes, basically, so it's much, much more similar than you think. For the next portion, I would like to recognize two students who are actually seniors in treble tempo. So I was hoping if Courtney and Taylor could come down and stand next to me, please. Yeah, don't wave, just walk over. These are two students who are seniors, and one of them we've had in choir for several years. Courtney's been with us, and Taylor actually just joined this year, which is outstanding. Both of them have just done such a wonderful job of being role models and positive influences on many of the students who stand behind you, and I'm so glad that you were with us for many years or decided to give choir a shot this year. She's like sight reading master over here with like no musical experience. It's awesome. So I just want to take this time to thank both of you so much. And as we head into our last song, Never Far From Home, the message for that song that we talked about in class is just that reminder that you have something familiar, you have something in this class, in this school, in this community, and I'm just so glad that choir was a part of your four-year journey here at high school, at Shadle Park High School. So I have two cards for you, but I just want to take this time to recognize our two seniors in treble tempos. Next up, we have our last choir of the evening, Highlander Chorale, our large advanced choir. And this one, we kind of have a theme going for this choir, and we start out with this journey we go together. And it has been a journey this year with these kids. They have done such exceptional work. We started the year with the Gonzaga Invitational, and we did large group this spring, and they just have done such a wonderful job working together as a class, as a community, really just to improve and be better, and they are doing a wonderful job this year. The first song we'll be singing is Come Travel With Me, which a few weeks ago when we sang at the first Northwest Choir Celebration, we were singing to middle schoolers and elementary schoolers, and it really was an invitation, like, come sing with us, keep doing what you want to do, keep doing music, whatever that may be, keep doing that for you. But then as we talked about that in class, it was an invitation to sing in this group with, like, 100%, just diving in and going 100% and being a part of this community. So we start with Come Travel With Me. For this class, there's a lot of kids, which means there's a lot of awards. So get comfortable, guys. Just that means you can stand in not choral posture. Nice job. There we go. Yes, there we go. There's the teenagers I know and love. So for the first one, we'll start with the most improved in Highlander Chorale. And this student came to us from a different middle school than most of their peers, only had about 1 year of choir experience, and showed up the first day and was like, I'm ready to do choir. And since then, this kid has had such a fantastic attitude to being a part of this community, to being engaged in class with a smile, with great energy, with great dance moves, and great clapping. Just a really wonderful student who's committed to getting better. And one of the things that I loved about this student about halfway through the year, one of the questions I ask on my concert questionnaire is like, what are you looking forward to improving at our next concert? And this student just on their own on the form wrote, I'm really looking forward to like seeing what I sound like this time next year. So they weren't even looking towards the next concert. They were looking towards a year from now when they're still in this ensemble and still doing awesome work. So this student has done, again, just a wonderful job trying to be a better singer, a better community member, someone I think we can all really look up to, but he's made fantastic improvements this year. So the student who's voted most improved goes to Eli. The next award we're going to give out is for our most inspirational award. And I feel like kids might know who this one goes to. Because if this person is not there in rehearsal, the first thing we ask when we start stretches, first thing is stretching right arm up. And the second thing is, where's Holly? If Holly's not there, we're like, where's Holly? Because she's just an absolute joy, which is her middle name, and just lights up the room. I've never heard her say a negative thing. Like, this concert could fall apart, and on Wednesday, she'd still be like, it was amazing, guys. Seriously, there's nothing negative. Do you say anything negative? I don't think so. It's just... Oh, good to know. She's just a wonderful inspiration to us, and we just really love seeing her every day, and we call her our mascot, and she's made us Vine compilations, and as you can see, she's just really beloved by the choir because she is a fantastic role model for what it means to be an inspiration to everyone. So, Holly, come on down. No. For the next one we have, we're going to do the student who's voted the outstanding student leader. So this can be anybody in the choir, any grade. This year it was a senior. And this person, I was really happy that they were recognized by their peers because much of her leadership I see and really helps me. But I was really happy to know that all of her peers saw that as well because she tries so hard to lead by example. She reminds others about the expectations in class while also sticking to those herself. So she's just a great role model for everyone. She is calm. She has a quiet demeanor, but is still an inspiration to everyone in this class, I think, because she's just like that constant we have in the alto section. She's been a fantastic leader this year. She's getting a four-year choir award later this evening. She's just really dedicated to this program and has been quietly leading from the alto section. So, Vanessa, thank you so much. And the fourth award we have up for this section is the Dorothy Hutchinson Memorial Award. And Dorothy Hutchinson was a wonderful patron of the arts, and she passed away several years ago. And many of the high schools in the area have an award in her honor, and it recognizes a student of the junior class who is really like improved the most and has worked really hard in their junior year to be a better singer and a better musician. I met this student when they were a freshman in treble tempos, and last year they worked really hard when they got to Highlander Chorale for the first time. And similarly to what they did in chamber choir, they also have been doing in Highlander, which is consistently asking for help, consistently spotting errors or spaces of weakness that the choir needs to work on. She's so observant. She's so diligent. And I've just been blown away by her progress and, again, just that diligence and commitment to being a better singer and to making this a better community. So all of her suggestions aren't just, oh, for me. It's for her section. It's for the choir, which is all teachers in the audience will know. Sometimes we just get, like, tunnel vision on one thing. And it's really great to have those kids step back and say, we need to work on this or I need help with this. I think it would be really great if we did this. And she is a student who does that. So for the Dorothy Hutchinson Memorial Award, I'm really excited to offer this to Emily Albury. Okay, last section of this awards. We're going to have our lettering ceremony. So if you know you're getting a letter or a pin this year, come on down. Lettering in choir is a possibility. And the students you see before you have either lettered for the first time or lettering for the second or third time. And they have to meet a criteria. You don't cry over this one. It's just a letter. It's a big fuzzy thing you put on a jacket. Sorry, it's the only way we're going to get through without tears is if I make those jokes. I apologize. So for lettering, they have to meet criteria, and then they get points on top of that. So the students you see before you have gone to other high school choir concerts, have gone to my choir concerts. Those are on the South Hill. That takes some commitment and some driving. Emily made it in the snowstorm once, so that's impressive. So these students have really just like shown what it means to go above and beyond to be a better singer, because you can't just be a better singer by being in your own community. You have to go out and see great examples of other art, and these students have really been committed to that. So they've done an awesome job this year, over 5 points, all of them. None of them just hit it. They all went above 6, 6.5, 7, so that's really awesome. It just shows a lot of commitment to the choir program. So students who are lettering for the first time this year will be Nate, Ty, Kenzie, Nat, Emily, and Shelby. And the next three students we have lettered. This will be their second time or their third time lettering. So they just get a pin to put that shows how many times they've reached that criteria. So the ones that remain before you, lettering for the second or third time, second time, third time, fourth time, third time. You missed the second time? Okay, there it is. Great. I just wanted to see. We have Emma, Vanessa, and Lizzie. All right, we made it to the first part. For our second song this evening, we'll be singing And So It Goes. And we talked a lot about what this song means, kind of like in the popular context, but then also what it means in the choir context. And what we boiled it down to was this song speaks about throwing yourself into something 100% fully open heart, ready to go into it, no matter what the outcome, what you know it to be. And in choir, we know that the outcome is that this group changes every year. But these students have come to me every day and started at the beginning of the year and made it to the end of the year to today with open hearts and just ready to sing their best until it's time for that group to change. So they've been really committed to doing their best that they can this year and just being ready for no matter what happens. So, And So It Goes. Before we sing our last set or last song this evening, we have to go through our senior awards. So the first one we'll be going through is the Director's Award. So that one is chosen by me, the director. And it's the definition that was given to me when I got at Shadle 3 years ago was a student, a senior, so I can just read it. A senior who has shown outstanding service to the choir program. So this is an award based off of her service to the choir program. And this year, the student has been a section leader and a choir president, a librarian, and a TA in class. And by TA in class, I mean every class, because she takes online classes. So she's just in my office all the time, which has come in handy for me, because what I tell the kids all the time is that I got into teaching for the music and for students and not for the paperwork and not for organizing the library. But this student, she has served the choir by really keeping the choir together, but then also by keeping me together, which is a big service, because then I could just focus on teaching, and that's what I love the most. But Emma Hollingshead has really done a fantastic job this year as an outstanding leader in this community, and she has absolutely given everything she has to this choir program for the last 4 years. She takes action when she sees I need help or someone else needs help. As I said earlier, she's just that absolute prime example of what a chorister should be, and I hope I have many more Emmas in my future, but she's a very special Emma. So Emma, come on down for your director's award. And in addition to that, I'd also like to invite down all of our seniors, 4 years or not, all of our seniors who are on stage right now, come on down to the front row. We have the four-year choir awards. Student gets medals with their names engraved on them. They get to wear them at graduation, and they've asked, can I wear them for the last song? And I've said yes. So if you're blinded by shiny metal, that's why. But some of these students have been in choir for all 4 years, and we know that's a really difficult thing to do now. Students are being pulled in every way, academics, activities, sports. But the students I'm about to call off have committed to 4 years of choir and really have made that a priority, which is fantastic. It looks great on college applications. It looked great on job applications. It's wonderful for our program. It's great for me, and it's wonderful for the students behind you to have your leadership all 4 years. So I got to have these students when they were sophomores, so I've only been with them for three, but I'm so glad they came back that second year to stick it out with the new choir teacher so I could work with them, because this is a really wonderful senior class. And in addition to that, we have a couple people who are not with us for 4 years, but they have been a wonderful part of this community, and so I still have cards for them as well, because we could not do it without them. So congratulations to the senior class in Highlander Chorale, and when I call your name, come get your medal and come get your card, and thank you for singing with us, and thank you for your service. Michelle, come on down. You're the first one with four-year medal award. And then Lizzie, come on over. We have Emma as well. And Vanessa. Shelby. And Carissa. And Tristan. And in addition to that, we also have Gio, who was new to choir this year and absolutely killed it. Congratulations, sir. And we have Nat as well, who should have been in choir for all 4 years. It didn't work out, though. And Chloe, also, so wonderful singing with you. Thank you so much. A final round of applause for our graduating seniors.
Hello, I am going to be taking the podium now. Sorry, Cam. So the seniors every year prepare something for Miss Cam, because of course, we all love her so much, and I must say I am jealous for her next senior class for having her for all 4 years. She is one of the best choir teachers I've ever had, and she's a great influencer for every single person in this choir. And I think they'll agree when I say that. So we would like to present with her. We every year put together a senior board for Miss Cam to remember us by, and I believe there it is.
Yay!
Yay! We would like to present Miss Cam with the senior board, class of 2019. And we also spent a lot of time making a scrapbook for her. We have a family board in the choir room where we post pictures of everyone in the choir, all of our events. So we put it all into a book for her to have.
Snacks. Thank you so much, senior class. You guys are wonderful. And now I just got to throw you right into that last song, so take a deep breath because we're ready to go. The last song we'll be singing for you for this evening, our last song in the last concert of the 2019 school year, is Holly, nothing negative. Thank you. is Oceans and Stars. And again, we had all these class conversations about what this means, and the basses actually said it best. They really dug deep that day by reminding us that all three songs in this set, from Come Travel With Me to And So It Goes, and then to Oceans and Stars, can be kind of summarized with the quote from Walt Disney, "Don't cry because it's over, but smile because it happened." And one of the things we talked about for this song is just that wonderful thing, that shared human experience of growing separately and supporting and watching someone grow from afar, but still being proud of their work and still being proud of their journey. So we've started this year together, and many of these students will go on to do lots of other wonderful things. But this song, Oceans and Stars, is just a reminder that we will always be here for you and we'll support you from where we are, and that's what this song is about. And so it's that final reminder for you, and for those of you returning next year, we get to start that journey all over again and get to do it again in the fall. So please enjoy our last song of the evening, Oceans and Stars.
Thank you.
And that, I think, is our last concert of the year. So thank you, everyone, so much for joining us this evening. Kids, get home safe. Chamber, don't show up tomorrow. There will be no zero hour. Thank you so much, everyone. Get home safe. Have a wonderful rest of your year. And thank you so much for joining us.